Hello everyone, welcome to another beautiful tutorial on Ajani Media and Designs. If this is your first time of being here, kindly subscribe to my channel so that you can be part of those that will be gaining from the knowledge I am sharing on this channel. If you are a teacher, this tutorial is for you. If you are a gamer, this tutorial is also for you. Because you can use this recording app I'm going to show you here to record your game and share with your audience across the world. And also, if you're a teacher, you can use this recording app to record your lesson and share with your student. So without much ado, let's go into the app proper. So the app I'm talking about is X Recorder. So I can see the icon. You can download this one from your app store, from Google Play Store or any other app store. So when you open it, so you can set it this one up while before you start to record. So you open the app and set it up. So when you open the app, this is what you are going to see. So first thing, to go to setting, click on the setting icon there. Then you set your resolution to 720p or 1080p depending on the resolution that you want. So the quality, you can set that one to, you can see now I cannot change that one because I'm already recording. So here you can set that one to 16 Mbps, that is megabit per second, or you can set it to the lower quality. So that one will depend on the size of the video. Then the FPS, frame per second, you can also set that one to 60 FPS, that is for 4K resolution. So if you desire 4K resolution video, you can come here and change it from auto to your desired resolution, or that's, I mean, your FPS. Then orientation, you can as well set that one to landscape or portrait, or you set it to auto. Then check the record audio so that you can pick the voice when you are recording. Then save location, you can select whichever location that you want. So, and then the number of available time that you can record will be shown here. Then system, repair system UI crash, so you leave that one for now. So don't tamper with that. So when, that has to do with advanced settings. So in the recording mode, you can set that one to normal or performance mode. Then countdown before start, you can change the seconds from 3 to 5 or 10 seconds, so depending on your choice. Then we have pop-up window after taking screenshots, so check that one so that when you take screenshot, you can know that the screenshot has actually been taken, so it will pop up. So that way, that is, it is good to set that one to should take pop-up. Then hide recording window during recording, so check that one so that the recording icon will be hidden. Then we have shake phone to stop recording. You can shake that one as well so that you can shake your phone and stop recording. Then keep recording while the screen is off, so you can also shake that one so that when your screen is off, then the recording can continue. Then these are the cool features I told you about at the beginning of this tutorial. So we have the first one, the screenshot. So you have to shake that one. You can see a camera icon has been what attached down here. That is, if anytime you want to take a screen shot, just tap on that camera. Then if you want to use camera for your recording, as you can see here, so you tap on that camera and you want to show your face, like now where I'm recording now. So you can see you can tap on this screen here and then reduce the size of the camera. So maybe you want to place your camera, like we are using webcam on your laptop. So here, so you can see your face, so you can click on this one to change the camera to a rear camera. So you can just come here and cancel camera if you don't need camera, so you can remove it. Then brush, so this is another cool feature. So when you click on brush, you can see this brush icon here. So when you tap on the brush, so the brush will now display the brushes available that you can use, especially for teachers. Maybe you want to illustrate something. So you can see the first one is selected when I draw what you see on the screen here. Then if you want to draw quadrilateral, so maybe square, rectangle, triangle, rectangle, sorry. So you want to draw rectangle, so you can use this one. Maybe as a teacher, you are doing lesson. So then circle, want to circle something. So then arrow, you can draw that one as well. Then another one, as you can see, then as you are drawing them on the screen, you can see. Then we press the camera icon. That one is to what? To take the screenshot. As you can see now, the screenshot is already taken and you can see a pop-up. Then we have the eraser, so you can use this one to clean. Then we have undo. Then this is one way you can change the color of these drawings here. So then you can cancel this one if you don't need it. Then another thing that you can do with this one, like I said before, that apart from recording your screen, you can also use this one for some basic photo or video editing. So if you click on this edit now, this pencil icon, you can see you can edit video. So when you click on video, you can import video. This is one of my recording here, so you can import this one, then click on this arrow here, so it will take you in the app where you can use the app to perform some editing. So as you can see, then you have to pay for the icon or watch some video to record, to remove the watermark of S recorder there. So these are the basic settings you can editing that you can perform on this video. You can stream it, so when you click on it, you can trim to the seconds that you want. Then when you are done, click on the mark there. Then speed, you want to change the speed, so you can do that as well. Copy, you want to copy it, you want to add music. So just continue. You can see you want to increase the volume or you want to decrease the volume. Then you can also add text to this ratio, then the ratio of the video depending on the platform that you are uploading it to. So you can see various ratio that you can use here. Then you can also see crop, then rotate the video. So as a video editor, I don't normally use this one for video editing, but as a starter, you can manipulate or you can make use of these features to edit your video and upload to your social media or any other platform. So when you are done, you click on save to save it. Then edit photo, can as well edit your photo. So you tap on that, then take it to which photo do you want to import. So click on the photo that you want to import, and from here you can see this one. You can crop it, crop this video. When you are done, click on the check mark there. Then brush, like I've shown before, so you can see the brush, the brushes available, arrow, square, and the rest. So once you click on any one of them, you can use, you can draw it on the what, on the photo. And when, if that is what you want to do, click on the check mark there. So, and then you also rotate your image. As you can see, you can rotate it. So then rotate. So when you are done, you click on the save at the top here to save the picture after you have edited it. So aside from the video and photo editing, you can also use it to merge video and photo. So you click on this one, so it will take you to where you have your video. You can select the video that you want, then tap on the photo and select the photo that you want, and then click on the arrow to take you to the app. So here you can combine both of them. From here, when you tap on the photo, the basic editing you can perform on the photo, you can see there. And when you are done, you click on save. So the last one I've talked about at the beginning, that as a teacher, I can also use this one to record my lesson and share with my student. You have to install Office application on your device. I have WPS on my device and I've prepared my slides for my lesson. So right now, to minimize this one and tap on the WPS, that is the presentation that I've already prepared for this. So if you're a teacher, I can use this one to record my lesson and share with my student. So here I have my slide. So if I click on this one, I come to play, then I say first page. So you tap on the first page, as you can see now, so it will take me to this place. As you can see that my lesson is ready now. So the slide is ready. So as I hear, as a teacher, I can begin by saying, okay, hello student, today I'm having another lesson, and the topic we shall be discussing today is software. So in this lesson, we are going to look at first thing, definition of software. So as a teacher, I can begin to explain this screen and then why the app will be recording it. So I can see as you are tapping on it, the next slide will be coming. So when you are done with this one, then we stop the recording and then take it to your editing app, video editing app, or you can use this app as well to edit the video and then save it and share it with your student. So you can see this app has some cool features. Apart from recording, I have shown you how you can use it to edit your video. I have shown you how you can use it to edit your picture, and I've also shown you how you can combine both video and photo. And lastly, as a teacher, and I've also shown you how you can use this app to prepare your lesson and share with your students. So if you have gained one or two things from this video, kindly give a thumb up, that is, you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share with your contacts so that they can also benefit from this tutorial. Thank you for your time in watching this video. I'm going to see you in my next tutorial.